What's going on, people? It's Flight Sports TV. I appreciate y'all for checking with me, man. Listen, I got a real nice topic for the people, man. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to talk about tonight. I want to talk about LaMelo Ball. He had an electrifying performance tonight. We're going to break it all down. The man was hovering around a triple-double. We got to pay homage. We got to pay heavy homage tonight. It's Flight Sports TV. You understand? I need everybody. Like I said, I hope everybody having a good night out there. You know, join our live. If you happen to catch this video right now, hit the bell on the icon for when we actually going live, because we could be going live at any second. And also, we may be live right now as we speak. So you want to be up to date on what's going on here at Flight Sports TV. I appreciate y'all for checking with me. I need everybody to hit that like button and most definitely hit that subscribe button if you're new. We really need to get some likes going because, like I said, the likes is really lagging. I don't know what's going on, but it doesn't cost anything to hit the like button. You understand? And if you're really rocking with Flight Sports TV, we need to make a collaborative effort to hit the like button. You understand? We got to come together. Before we get into the topic tonight, I need everybody to check out our Big Baller Brand Racing interview today with Marcus Johnson, the creator of Big Baller Brand Racing, co-created with LeVar Ball in conjunction. You know, it was spectacular. Like I said, we're doing big things around here as Flight Sports. We have breaking news today with Jello. It's just been an action-packed evening, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get straight into it. We were live for live streaming the Hornets Miami Heat game. The game was a spectacular game. I don't think anybody could have asked for anything, especially in preseason play. The stars did not play tonight. Butler didn't play. Rozier didn't play. Mr. Glass, my man Gordon Hayward didn't play, but I want to really shine the flashlight tonight on Mr. LaMelo Ball. Like I said, the man played 26 minutes. He seemed to be finding his offense. He didn't really force nothing tonight. He really let it come to him. You know, the man had 19 points, 9 assists, and 8 rebounds. And I felt like if it was the regular season, the man would have had a high triple-double. I mean, going up in the 20s, I would say 27, 26. That's why here at Flight Sports TV, if LaMelo could start averaging, LaMelo's a 20-plus point per game scorer. You understand? The man is going to average 20 points per game, over 20 points per game in his career. You understand? It's going to happen. It's not about if. It's all about when. It's just when is it going to happen. It's not about if. So tonight, it was just an electrifying performance. He showed today why he should have been the number one overall pick in that draft that just passed. It was crazy. This year, he's going to separate himself from all the rookies that was in his class, you know, especially Anthony Edwards, because I still think right now it's some speculation on between him and Mr. Anthony Edwards. Also tonight, Miles Bridges had a great game tonight. Airbnb was in complete effect. Cody Martin balled tonight. If you want to say they picked the right brother, because Cody Martin got hot at the three-point line this evening. It was crazy. You understand? This team is showing some serious great flashes because even the Hornets, I'm evaluating them similar to how I evaluate the Bulls and Lonzo. I'm not taking too much into this. I'm just seeing the flashes. Lonzo put up a 19-point per game as well. You understand? 19-point game as well as LaMelo did. What I'm seeing from LaMelo was different from Lonzo, the flashes. With LaMelo, what I'm seeing is a guy who could score quicker with a quicker clip. Like, LaMelo, it ain't going to take him. You see, the man had 19 in 26 minutes, and this is preseason. Could you imagine what he would have did in 26 minutes if he was dead serious? You understand? That's what I'm seeing when it comes to preseason play. Because, like, he's not going to play 26 minutes in the regular season. The man is going to average, you could double that. Just add 10 to that. You understand? I could see him playing about, you know, 35, somewhere in that range. You understand? Maybe more than that. I'm just being generous. You understand? The man could be playing damn near 40 minutes, 38, 39, things of that nature. So expect for everything to get a little bit inflated. I think LaMelo is starting to understand the NBA game a little bit more than he did when he first came into the league. You know, he's starting to understand time of possession, what to do in certain situations. things are just coming to him a little bit easier than it once did. You know, so we got to definitely, like I said, we got to pay heavy homage on Mr. LaMelo Ball on that front. You understand? The man is going to be one of the elite point guards we have in this league. You understand? I don't know who you compare LaMelo to, if you have any comparisons. Have we seen a player like Melo before? I'm starting to believe we haven't seen a player like this. You know, he's very nonchalant, but you could tell he's arrogant. You know, and all of this is just, this is great, compliments. None of this is a knock to LaMelo. And all of these things, these qualities that LaMelo embodies and shows on the court is going to make him an even better basketball player. You understand? That's going to make him an even better player. LaMelo Ball is going to take the next step going into year two. You understand? But and he has to. And these other guys, it can't just be LaMelo. You know, we're going to need the Cody Martins to play like this every night. We need Miles Bridges to take that next step. We need PJ to be a force out there. You know, I think oftentimes with the Hornets, we so caught up in what LaMelo does, what he did when they fall. These other players have to develop as well. We know what we're getting from Melo. What we getting from PJ on a consistent basis? You understand? What we going to get from Book Knight? You understand? Book Knight could put up 20. Book Knight could put up 9. That's what I'm saying. You really don't know. Ish Smith is very erratic. Some of these guys, Terry Rozier, you really don't know what you're going to get from a game-to-game basis. You understand? The Kelly Oubres, even though they didn't play tonight, you don't really know what you're going to get. You understand? So these guys got to develop some consistency, you know, and establish themselves on the floor, you know, because LaMelo is going to need these guys, you know, especially if they're trying to make the playoffs, because the East is fully loaded. You see the Chicago Bulls, you see Indiana, and mind you, I'm talking about teams right now who didn't make the playoffs. You understand? And you look at Washington, they've retooled. They was the 8th seed. You understand? Boston was the 7th seed. You know, so this shows you how deep the Eastern Conference is. It's gonna take everything for the Hornets to make the playoffs this season. You know, because they're an uphill battle. You know, let me know the chances y'all have of the Hornets making the playoffs. I think they will. You know, it may come via the play-in tournament. You know, because they will have to get really hot, and they're gonna have to pass a lot of teams to get to that 6th seed. I think the NBA might need to get it thrown away with this tournament. I don't know. What do y'all think about the play-in tournament? Maybe it is a little competitive, but I'm sorry. I just like the way how it used to be, you know. But this is cool. It gives other teams a shot. So I think that's cool. I don't want them ever to, like, mix up the playoff seedings, you know, whereas you're going to have a situation where you're in the playoffs and you got the Knicks facing the Memphis Grizzlies or the Knicks facing, you know, Phoenix in the playoff. Like, that'd be a disaster. You understand? I don't want them to ever do nothing like that. They already fooled with the All-Star game. You know, East versus West, that needs to come back. I don't like how they doing this, where they got these captains and you got players from both conferences just all shuffled. I don't like that. You know, they need to bring it back to how it was. You know, but that's a little off topic. Nonetheless, tonight, LaMelo Ball electrified. You understand? We got to give credit. The man is going to be an electrifying player his whole career. You know, and we've seen flashes all preseason long, and it wasn't more evident than it was tonight. You know, we've seen it live and direct tonight. 19-9-8 in preseason play. That shows me right away that LaMelo Ball has been improving. You understand? This man didn't just sit down on the couch this summer. You understand? The man been grinding. He wasn't just happy with winning Rookie of the Year. And he coming back for blood. You know, he hit some confident jumpers tonight. He took it to the basket. He finished over contact. And like I said, I seen a little bit of talking, a little bit of trash talking. He was feeling good. And that's going to be great for the Hornets headed into the playoffs. You know, I mean, headed into the regular season where guys are feeling confident. You want LaMelo feeling good. These guys are playing again Wednesday against the Dallas Mavericks. Make sure y'all tune in for that. That should be a tough game for them. You know, that's going to be tough. That will not be easy. You know, and that's preseason play. That would be the final preseason game. And then, which is Wednesday. And then following that, a week from Wednesday, you have that opener at 7 o'clock. So, It's gonna be great. Everybody's pretty much opening up at 7 o'clock against the Pacers. You know, so y'all be on the lookout for that. We're gonna be here tuned in to Flight Sports TV. Hit that like button and most definitely hit that subscribe button. We're getting up out of here. Check out all the content we pushing out. It's Flight Sports.